What's poppin', my people? Welcome back to another video, The Radical Latino. Remember, this is going to be way different from my podcast. If you guys want to listen to my podcast, things I'm not going to include on YouTube or things I'm going to further add to YouTube, make sure you go to my podcast, link in the description down below. Now, let's get into the shits. Now, this lady, this white, inbred looking, pale in the face, I eat mayonnaise for breakfast, I drink milk for dinner. Her name online is Corner Store Carol. Corner Store Carol, right? That's her name online, Corner Store Carol. But her real name is Teresa Klein. So, why is this piece of shit up in the news? Because of this.
There's Bureau. No, I want the cops here right now.
No.
I'll talk
to you.
I'm gonna stay right here. I'm gonna stay right here.
The cops are right down the block. I can go find.
That's right. The son grabbed my ass.
She said
and she decided to yell at me.
So I'm gonna stay right here.
There are security cameras.
Let me go. Don't say no way.
Go home.
Let's make it go viral.
Go home. No.
No, not her.
No, no.
Go to store, Carolyn. That's what that is. Don't cry, little man. Don't cry, little man.
Yo.
Because she's calling the cop. That's corner store, Carolyn.
You
got a new one.
Who would want to touch
corner store, Carolyn. Look at that. Hold on. She calling police.
Yep. This white supremacist female accused a 9-year-old boy of sexually assaulting her. Remember, take very close attention, keep on what she says. She clearly is accusing a 9-year-old boy of sexually assaulting her. This 9-year-old boy doesn't even have enough testosterone in his body to even know what sexual assault is or to even like get hard for a female. But yet she's accusing this 9-year-old boy of sexually assaulting her. Now, why I told you to... I'm gonna break this whole thing down. Now, in the media, you guys been seeing the Me Too movement. You guys have been seeing the countless of men getting accused left and right by white women. Now, obviously, in the social construct of things, things are gonna be a lot bigger than what it is, you know, and now the conversation is we have to protect white women. We have to protect white women. This is going back to the Emmett Till days. This is going back actually way before anything, where white women are considered pure. White women are considered something that we have to protect. Why? It's because of white supremacy. We cannot have our white women sullied, violated, tainted by black. It doesn't matter what it is, as long as you're black or you're non-white, you shouldn't even be tainted. You know what I'm saying? But it goes back to that. So we're seeing a retelling of the same thing happen now. You feel me? So with the whole Me Too movement, you know what I'm saying? So we're seeing all of that. Now, obviously, this woman is gonna say, hey, he sexually assaulted me. He did this, he did that. You know what I'm saying? Because those are code words. Those are white supremacist code words that this woman and other people like this woman put out there so they could get someone black either killed or in jail, fucking up their whole life. So white women throughout history have done this. Any white woman that started crying, the first thing they'll accuse is a black person. Years ago, this was a case of this white girl ran into a church all bloodied up and said three black men raped her and kidnapped her. Ended up being a lie, but everybody believed it. If she would have said, no, it was like a bunch of white boys, they wouldn't have gone so hard. Remember the that woman in Florida, the woman that killed her kid. I forgot her name just now. But the first thing she said was, a group of black men came and, you know, took my car and all that shit. Like, you know, they jacked me up. You know what I'm saying? So it's been a countless thing that white women will blame black people, especially black men, because throughout history it's going to be believable. These black people don't even have to exist. They, as long as a white woman is saying something, it's going to be believable. Now, this white woman blamed this 9-year-old boy of sexually assaulting her because, you know, she's saying the white supremacist code words and all that other shit. But that goes to show what she's been taught. That goes to show her real views. It doesn't really matter how old the black person is. All black men are sexual deviants to her. All black men are sexual predators to her. How do I know this? It's because she blamed a 9-year-old boy of sexually assaulting her. That's why. Surveillance tape came out saying that that wasn't true.
Yes, sir. Egg and cheese on the roll. Salt, pepper, ketchup.
God. Yeah, she was wrong. Yeah, like 5 witnesses who saw it.
No, I see. I spoke to that lady in the blue shirt.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah, you guys see that? His backpack brushed up against it. That's it. That's it. His backpack just brushed up against it. Brushed up against her flat pancake, no having back. Longer than any other human being, no butt cheeks, just an asshole type of bitch. A backpack brushed up against, I don't even think it touched her ass. I think it touched her lower back. And she confused that as her ass because, you know, she got no ass. You know what I'm saying? Look at her. She's plain as fuck. But anyway, so a backpack just brushed up against her and now, oh, sexual assault, blah, 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 and all this other shit. Now, she's been interviewed by news media, and guess what? She's out here lying her ass off.
Sexually assaulted by a child.
But the situation only escalates. The video is uploaded to Facebook, where it almost immediately goes viral. That woman, identified as Teresa Klein, is soon dubbed by the internet as Corner Store Caroline. Just the latest moniker in a series of incidents where a white person calls the police on a black person, clearly showing him walking by, rushing out to leave with his family.
I was standing at the counter. I was sexually assaulted.
The woman at the center of the controversy is sticking to her account, speaking exclusively with Pix 11 outside her home, where she says she's been harassed after the video went viral.
I understand how it looks, but she escalated. And then I lost my temper at her, not at that child.
Accusing the boy's mother of threatening her in person and later in a voicemail, Klein made numerous accusations, even saying during the now viral altercation that it was the child's mother who claimed she was a police officer, despite the footage clearly showing otherwise.
Yeah, go ahead.
I'm a cop.
All right, so if you're a cop, then you should have
I did not say that. If I did say that, I would be surprised.
You see that? She clearly says she was a cop, I'm a cop, and all this other shit. And she was like, no, I didn't say that shit. Get the fuck out of here. These white supremacists are dangerous, family. I'm telling you, these white supremacists are dangerous. We've seen it with Barbecue Becky. We've seen it with a bunch of other people, the pool lady and all them shit. We've seen it with all these other people, I'm telling you. These people are dangerous, okay? And they're just getting caught out there in their bullshit. And I'm glad that they're being caught out there in their bullshit because now we're actually seeing what the fuck is really going on out here. You know what I'm saying? I'm glad they're being caught out in the bullshit. And I'm glad that these things are going viral and these people are getting on blast. I love that. I'm glad. I love that shit. You feel me? So, the thing is, now the community is coming out and they're gonna have a meeting today at 5:30. I know I'm doing this shit wild late. I'm doing it on Monday, which is today, that they're gonna have the meeting around 5. But they're gonna have a meeting, and this is the thing. I don't give a fuck how many meetings you have, how many people show up, on what they're gonna say, how they feel, on what's going on in this community. Oh my god, the outrage. Because it's gonna go from that corner store bullshit to something else that has nothing to do with what we're talking about. You know what I'm saying? I do not care. As long as they start pressing some charges to this woman. What kind of charges? Harassment. Let's start seeing and start pressing harassment charges to this woman, okay? And also on top of that, let's see if we can actually put more charges, because she impersonated a cop. She pretended to be a cop. So let's actually, you know, press some charges on that. You know what I'm saying? She committed a crime. Let's really see. You know what I'm saying? And if you guys live outside of New York or are in New York and can't attend the meeting, but you want your voice heard, remember, contact the Brooklyn DA, the Brooklyn District Attorney, all right? The head person is Eric Gonzalez. I'm putting that up right now. You could contact them, and their phone number is 718-250-2340. Contact them. I already did that.
DA's office, good afternoon.
Good afternoon. My name is... I'm calling because... Would I be able to talk to Eric Gonzalez, please?
Okay, and what is... what you said your name is? All right, let me get someone to assist you. Stay on the line.
No problem.
Can I have someone give you a call back at this number, 609-948-4194?
Yeah, that's not a problem. Can you take a message down also?
I didn't get that.
Can you take a message down, please?
Yeah, what is the message?
The message is basically I would like to have a follow-up and want to know what the current situation is going to be with the Brooklyn resident under the name of Teresa Klein. She's been all over the media, so I just
okay, we have a high volume of those calls coming.
Yeah, I just wanted to know.
Reach out to you.
No problem. Thank you.
You said 609-948-4194.
Yeah.
Thank you. Someone is going to reach out to you.
Not a problem. Thank you. Bye.
Bye-bye.
You heard? So I already did that. I left a message with the secretary, and guess what? I'm still contacting them tomorrow and the next day and the next day and the next day, because charges need to be filed against this woman, all right? She committed some violent act, okay? She committed a violent act. Why is this violent? Because she harassed a 9-year-old kid, all right? She harassed a 9-year-old kid. White people will not allow their kids to be basically victimized, all right? And we shouldn't allow this either, all right? So if you guys like what you heard, you guys like what you saw, hit me up on Twitter, Instagram. You already see it's up on the screen. Radical_Latino_ for both Twitter and Instagram. Leave a comment. Let's see what you guys think. All right? Peace.